إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. My brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is our sixth lecture from the series towards understanding سورة الفاتحة, تفسير سورة الفاتحة, and this is lecture number six. And whether you believe it or not, we're actually going to start the surah. The first verse, Alhamdu lillahi rabbil alameen. Kama bada Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khalqal khalqi bilhamdi iftataha kitabahu bilhamdi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started creating the creation with His praise. قال تعالى الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created the heavens and the earth, and He made the darkness and the light. الحمد لله فاطر السماوات والأرض. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who fashioned the heavens and the earth. Also, by the virtue of the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah owns everything in the heavens and the earth. Alhamdulillah alladhi lahu ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creating the creation, and then someone else will take charge of it. You should say alhamdulillah that Allah still owns it. Imagine someone owning the sun, someone in control of the sun to give you heat. You must pay the bill. Somebody owning the air, the oxygen. Allah still owns all of this. That's why you say Alhamdulillah alladhi lahu ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. By His praise also He revealed the books which guide us. Alhamdulillah alladhi anzala ala abdihi alkitab. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who brought down the book on His servant. And He told us, وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. You should say, Alhamdulillah that He did not take a son. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ. Say, Alhamdulillah that Allah does not have a partner. Ya ikhwa, in our businesses, when do you need a partner? When you don't have enough capital. When you want protection, you go to somebody who's dhahr, he's well off, he can get the paperwork taken care of for you. And when you get in trouble, he can protect you. He can pay somebody off. He know a congressman, a senator, get things going. Or you don't have enough money to support the project. Say Alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need a partner. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala having a partner. then you're going to have to serve that partner as well. ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجلا سلما لرجل. Imagine a slave serving one master and a slave serving 10 masters. And they don't like one another. The masters do not like one another. Which one will have a peace of mind? The one who is serving one master. Say Alhamdulillah, الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك. He has no partners in his dominion and kingship. ولم يكن له ولي من الذل. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need a wali because he is imperfect. He is humiliated. Subhanallah an hadha. No, he is all powerful. So you should say, you must say, Alhamdulillah. And he actually commanded us to say, Alhamdulillah. Say Alhamdulillah. When you ask a Muslim now, Ya Ikhwa, how are you, brother? Terrible, awful. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Say Alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begun his revelation, his Quran, with Alhamdulillah. يقول ابن جرير الطبري رحمه الله commenting about this verse, الحمد لله ثناء أثنى به الله على نفسه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised himself by saying it. وفي ضمنه أمر لعباده بالثناء عليه. And in that there is a command to his servants to say الحمد لله. قل الحمد لله. Say الحمد لله. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the tongue of his messenger made it mandatory for you to say Alhamdulillah in each rak'ah, made it a pillar of the salah. Isn't reciting al-Fatiha a pillar of the salah? If you skip al-Fatiha, will your salah be valid? It will be invalid. Isn't Alhamdulillah for sure a verse from al-Fatiha? If you skip reciting Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen from al-Fatiha, will your Fatiha be valid? As a result of this, your Salah is invalid. Hear this, and if you get this, you will enjoy it. Alhamdulillah huwa shukr lillah, is saying thank you Allah. But using the term Alhamdulillah is special to Allah. If you do something to me as a human being, can I say Alhamdulak? Can I? La. I say Shukran. جزاك الله خير. But with Allah, الحمد لله. هو ثناء. In a way you're praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying shukran in it. فالحمد لله ثناء لله. When you say Alhamdulillah, you're praising Allah, and meanwhile you are saying thank you, O Allah. وَالثَّنَاءُ. Listen to this. Here's what I'm looking for. When you praise Allah, you're making dua. I shared with you last week dua al-karb. What is dua al-karb? when you're going through hardship, when you're troubled, you're needing help right now. Let's say you're drowning. Let's say you're drowning, you're swimming and you happen to drown. Hada karb, this is distress. Now what should you say? لا إله إلا الله العظيم الحليم لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم لا إله إلا الله رب السماوات ورب الأرض ورب العرش الكريم لا إله إلا الله There is no other deity worthy of my worship and submission but Allah Repeat it. Did you ask Allah for anything? But here's what they say. When you engage in praising Allah, Allah will give you what you want. As if I need a need. I have a need. I have immediate need. I need something from you. And instead of asking you for what I want, I get engaged in praising you. Then Allah knows what I want. He will give it to you. Yani, I came across Sufyan ibn Uyayna. When they ask him about this dua, dua al-karb. Where is the dua here? Where is the supplication? You're distressed and you're needing help. And you end up what? Praising Allah by Tawheed, saying La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim, La ilaha illallah Rabb al-arsh al-azim, La ilaha illallah Rabb al-samawati wa Rabb al-ardi wa Rabb. You're praising Allah. That's all you're doing, really, by mentioning the kalima, the Tawheed, in so many ways. The same exact thing with Sayyidina Yunus, Jonah, alayhi salam, when he found himself in the womb of the whale. What did he say? وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ What? لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ Huh? He's supposed to ask for what? I'm in the belly of the whale. Get me out of here, O Allah. I am in... No, he got engaged with what? Praising Allah with Tawheed. فسفيان بن عيينة was asked دعاء الكرب this دعاء دعاء ابن عباس ابن عباس the narrator is ابن عباس the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentions that if you're going through distress then say so and so so they ask him where is the دعاء the person is distressed he's supposed to be making دعاء you know what he said ألم تقرأ ما قال أمية بن الصلت لعبد الله بن جدعان أمية بن الصلت is a poem a guy who does what a poet I'm sorry who does what say what poem شعر بس إيه أستاذ عبد الله بن جدعان مين عبد الله بن جدعان عبد الله بن جدعان brothers and sisters in Islam was known to be so generous He used to feed all the Hajjaj. Remember, imagine now you're having 4 million people in the Haram. Okay, I'm feeding everybody. The containers of food used to be as high as 2 camels. ولذلك عائشة رضي الله عنها كما في الصحيحين she asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رسول الله عبد الله بن جدعان هذا used to be so generous. كان يفعل كذا وكذا 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 He used to feed the Hajjaj He used to be do this Will he get something in the next life? He said no صلى الله عليه وسلم إنه لم يقل يوما رب اغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين He said this He did this to be known to be generous And that goes to brothers and sisters who tackled Mama this and Baba this and Teresa and مش عارف مين يا أخي والله without لا إله إلا الله nothing notarization التوحيد مثل الذين كفروا بربهم أعمالهم كرماد اشتدت به الريح في يوم عاصف. The likeness of the deeds of those who disbelieve in Allah, do not say La ilaha illallah, even if they do a lot of righteous deeds, their deeds in the day of resurrection will be like ashes in a windy day. وقدمنا إلى ما عملوا من عمل فجعلناه هباء منثور. فأمية بن الصلت is saying poem in this generous man. You know what he's telling him? أأذكر حاجتي أم كفاني حياؤك فإن شيمتك الحياء إذا أثنى عليك المرء يوما كفاه من تعرضه الثناء. يعني look at this. Should I ask you what I want? But I know one of your qualities that you're shy. Meaning if somebody comes and he expresses praises of you, you will give him. فإن شيمتك الحياء. يعني when you come to me and say, Masha'Allah, may Allah reward you. Sheikh, you're Masha'Allah, you're this and that. Sheikh, Masha'Allah, you're this. You're praising me. He wants something. This is what he's saying. أذكر حاجتي أم كفاني حياؤك. يعني when you go to somebody and praise him, may Allah reward you, you are this, you are that. And but by the way, we're banned from praising people, huh? We're banned from doing this. Or is it sufficient for me that you're shy? You will shy away. ما هو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الله حيي. One of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, حيي. يستحي أن يرفع إليه العبد يديه ثم يردهما إيه صفرا. Allah is shy in the sense that you raise your hand and you ask him for something and he doesn't give it to you. Oh, so he's saying to Abdullah ibn Jud'an, I'm not going to mention what I want. All what I need to do is I want to praise you. And by praising you, will figure out that I want something from you. نفس الكلام يا إخوة. الحمد لله ثناء. You're praising Allah. And at the same time, you're saying thank you to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you say الحمد لله, الحمد لله, الحمد لله يا إخوة, this is a problem in the ummah right now. You ask an average Muslim, how are you? Terrible, awful. Say الحمد لله, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what you have. Enough يا أخي الإسلام, enough الإسلام, it's sufficient for you that you're a Muslim. يا إخوة, يؤتى بأبأس أهل الأرض يوم القيامة من أهل الجنة. The most miserable person in the day of resurrection. Hadith Sahih Muslim, Hadith Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. Imagine someone who had the most miserable life. Poor, ما فيش فلوس, problem, sick, miserable. But he's a Muslim, he has an Islam. He will be dipped one time, taken out. Have you seen misery before this? Over. Enough al-Islam. Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Islam. Wa kafa biha ni'mah. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the bounty of al-Islam. And it is sufficient of a ni'mah. Imagine you having the dunya, the world. Wa yu'ta bi an'ami ahli al-ard min ahli al-nar. Someone who had it all figured out in the dunya. He will be dipped one time in the hellfire. Have you seen fun before this? Forgot it. فالحمد لله رب العالمين. والحمد لله يا إخوة, الحمد لله هي لغة الصلاة لجميع المخلوقات. the language with which the rest of the creation praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِهَا يُرْزَقُوا سيدنا نوح عليه السلام الحديث في مسند أحمد حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص when he was about to die he called upon his two sons he said to them إني قاص عليكم الوصية I wanna leave my will to you أوصيكم باثنتين وأنهاكم عن اثنتين I want you to make sure that you take care of two things and you stay away from two things. أوصيكم بلا إله إلا الله. Be mindful of لا إله إلا الله. Never lose it. Never come up with something which will invalidate it. The second, وأوصيكم بسبحان الله وبحمده. نوح say سبحان الله وبحمده فهي صلاة كل شيء the prayers of this they say سبحان الله وبحمده this everything Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran in سورة الإسراء تسبح له السماوات السبع والأرض ومن فيهن وَإِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ هذا ما قاله نوح Everything in the face of this earth says سبحان الله وبحمده This is their salah وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ But you're unable to comprehend their tasbih Everything says سبحان الله وبحمده ولذلك يا إخوة أمرنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن نسبح الله وأن نحمده يعني سبحان الله when he would wake up at night to pray tahajjud you know the first thing that he would say what الحمد لله In the middle of the night. اللهم لك الحمد أنت نور السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. اللهم لك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. Oh Allah, to you all the praise. You are the light of the heavens and the earth. Oh Allah, all praise to you because you sustain the heavens and the earth and everything in the heavens and the earth. Allahumma laka alhamdu anta alhaq. All praise be to you, oh Allah, you are the truth. And what you say is the truth, the messengers is the truth. Dua. صلى الله عليه وسلم when he would hear good news somebody comes to him and says oh messenger of Allah we got this thing taken care of he would say الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات Anas says إذا جاءه صلى الله عليه وسلم الأمر يسر when he receives good news he would say all praise be to Allah Because of him, this was completed. And when he hears bad news, Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. Subhanallah. Bad news. Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. Hamd ya ikhwa. Ubudiyat al-shukr, hadhihi is missing in earth. We're all supposed to say Alhamdulillah. الحمد لله شوف the last scene in the day of resurrection وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين. When things are settled, angels will be around the throne. And their issues also are settled. And they will say, الحمد لله رب العالمين. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he sees somebody inflicted with a bad thing, with a calamity, he would say what? الحمد لله الذي عافاني مما ابتلى به هذا وفضلني. When you pass by a car wreck on the highway, man, this guy really got it. لا, say الحمد لله. You could be that person. Say الحمد لله who spared me from that. I could have been that person. And he preferred me above this person. الحمد لله الذي عافاني. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya ikhwah, subhanallah, likes to be praised. في صحيح مسلم, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إن الله لا يرضى من العبد أن يأكل الأكلة فيحمده عليها ويشرب الشربة فيحمده عليها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves from his servant when he eats a meal, he says Alhamdulillah. Subhanallah, ya akhi, a meal, a table filled bi atayib al-ta'am, all type of food in front of you, and the majority of people, they never say Bismillah. لا يذكر اسم الله عليها. And when he is done, لا يحمد الله. He never says الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي أطعمنا وسقانا وجعلنا مسلمين. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who given us water and drink and he made us Muslims. حتى يعني سبحان الله, يعني أبو بكر الصديق, one time he went to relieve himself and it seemed like he was having a hard time. Imagine the food is stuck in your belly and it doesn't go out. Constipation. So he went to the bathroom and he came out. You know what he said? يا لها من نعمة غفل عنها كثير من الناس. والله, this is a bounty that a lot of people are unaware of, that you're able to relieve yourself. Imagine people have to take that stuff out with a tube. نعم يا إخوة, نعم, نعم. يعني we always say this, that we look at the empty side of the cup, but we never see what we have. And Allah said this in the Quran, وَقَلِيل قَلِيل مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Very few of my servants are grateful to me. Subhanallah. يعني there is a predecessor, his name is Bakr ibn Abdullah al-Muzani. مر على رجل حمالا يحمل حطبا. He passed by some person who carries the straw and, يعني, for people, يعني, he helps them carry, move their stuff like a transporter but using his back. And he heard him saying all the time, الحمد لله وأستغفر الله, الحمد لله وأستغفر الله, الحمد لله وأستغفر الله. فبكر بن عبد الله, he's a known, learned predecessor, he said, ألا تعرف غيرها, don't you know anything else, ألا تحسن غيرها, don't you know anything else that you can say. فقال أعرف غيرها كثير. I know a lot of other things. أنا أحفظ القرآن. I memorize the Quran. ولكني أرى أن العبد بين نعمة لا يؤدي شكرها وذنب لا بد له من الاستغفار منه. But I always see العبد, the servant of Allah, is between two conditions. Allah has bestowed upon him a ni'mah, a bounty. He never said alhamdulillah for it. That is why I'm saying alhamdulillah. Or he committed a sin that he needs to repent of. That is why I'm saying astaghfirullah. Fabaka, he cried. And he said, hammalan lilhatat afqahu minni. Someone who is carrying, subhanallah, a transporter, some guy who carries stuff, is more learned than me. Ya ikhwa, we have a story, subhanallah, out of this world. Imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim, they compiled it. Hadith Abi Hurairah, radiyallahu anhu. Three individuals from Bani Israel. Allah wanted to test them. A leopard, abras, bold, aqra, a'ma, a blind. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the leopard an angel. And he asked him, what do you want? قال جلد حسن ولون حسن لقد قذرني الناس. I want a good skin and a good color. People are disgusted with me. You know, imagine a person who's a leper, people cannot sit around him. They run away because leprosy is what? Could infect, could be. فمسح على جسمه. He wiped over his body. فأعطاه الله جلدا حسنا ولونا حسنا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving him a good skin and a good color. ما تحب من المال. He was poor too. What do you want? What kind of wealth do you want? قال الإبل. I like camels. فأعطاه ناقة عشراء. He given to him a pregnant camel, female young. ودعا. اللهم بارك له فيه. Bless it for him. Then he went to the bolt. He went to the bolt. أقرع مش القرع. If you're bold, by the way, don't feel bad. His hair, his head is sick. القرع اللي هو sickness. What do you want? قال شعر حسن. I want to have good hair. People look down upon me. فمسح على رأسه. He wiped over his head and his hair was restored. And he was poor too. What kind of wealth do you want? قال البقر. Cows. فأعطاه بقرة عشراء. A pregnant cow. اللهم بارك له فيها. Bless it for him. ثم أتى الأعمى. Then he came to the blind. What do you want? قال أن يرد الله علي بصري. فأبصر الناس. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restores my vision for me so I can see people. فمسح على عيني. He wiped over his eyes. His vision was restored. What kind of wealth do you want? قال الغنم. Sheep. فأعطي غنمة ولودا. He was given a sheep with baby sheep. And he left them for a while. Their wealth multiplied, that delivered, had a valley filled with camels. The bull had a valley filled with cows. And the blind had a valley filled with sheep and goats. Now is the test. Now is the test. Are you going to be grateful? Are you going to remember that who gave you this? إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَكَفُورٌ. Mankind is ungrateful. He given you the life that you have. Who? Where were you before this dunya? Look at the nature of the test now, leaving no excuse for them. The angel took the form of a man and a leopard man. He came to him, to the man who used to be a leopard and who has a valley filled with camels. عابر سبيل, a wayfarer. تقطعت به السبل, I have nowhere else to go. ناقة, just one camel that can help me to go home. Please. Look. يا هذا, أو سو أن سو, الحقوق كثيرة. I have a lot of obligations. لئيم, لؤم يا إخوة. الإنسان اللئيم, the person who's ungrateful, he lies too. He would lie. He said to him, كأني أعرفك. You look so familiar. ألم تكن أبرصا فشفاك الله؟ ألم تكن فقيرا فأغناك الله؟ Weren't you leopard and Allah healed you? Weren't you poor and Allah giving you all this wealth? You know what he said? ورثته كابرا عن كابر. No, I'm sorry, I inherited this wealth from my ancestors. شايف؟ When you become grateful with Allah, you will never be guided. Never. When you cannot see the bounties of Allah upon you, you will never be guided to Islam. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divided mankind into two groups. إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا. شَاكِرًا, by the way, means a believer. لِنِّ شُكْرُ النِّعْمَةِ. When you're able to see the bounty of Allah upon you, will lead you, اللي هو الربوبية, the lordship of Allah, will lead you to الألوهية, will lead you to submit to Allah. كفورا, he were unable to see the bounty of Allah upon him. And this will never lead him to submit to الإله. Oh. شوف, lies. Denying. فقال الملك, the angel said, إن كنت كاذبا ردك الله إلى ما كنت. If you are lying, may Allah bring you back to previous condition. Leopard, the wealth is gone. He didn't say Alhamdulillah. He didn't admit that Allah given him that. He denied the bestower. Then he went to the bolt, sharhu, the same thing. حرام عليك. ويف يعني سبحان الله، هذا الرجل he had a valley filled with camels. He want just one camel. One camel. The next one, the one who used to be bold, wayfarer, عابر سبيل, help me please, please help me, just one cow that I can sell so I can go home. I don't have anybody else to help me, please. يا هذا أو so and so, I have a lot of obligations. الحقوق كثيرة. ألم تكن, weren't you bold and Allah restored you your hair, weren't you poor and Allah given you that wealth? No. ورثته كابرا عن كابر. إن كنت كاذبا صيرك الله إلى ما كنت. If you are lying, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take you back. Bold, poor, again. Then he went to the blind. يا هذا عابر سبيل, wayfarer, needing help to go home. تقطعت بي السبل. Just give me one sheep to take me home so I can sell it and I can go home. فقال له يا هذا, he said to him so and so, والله لقد كنت أعمى فأبصرني الله فرد الله علي بصري وكنت فقيرا فأعطاني الله ما ترى خذ ما شئت والله لا أقول لك لا. هذه الشكران يا إخوة, شكران النعمة, الشكر, عبودية الشكر. يعني سبحان الله, one of the ways that show that you're grateful that you mention your condition before what you have. I always tell the people that when I was in elementary school, I used to ride the donkey to school. Right now, alhamdulillah, I have a jeep. From donkey to subhanallah. Remember, where were you before this? Before what you have? The problem is we forget. Where were you beforehand? Umar, ya ikhwa, ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, one day he was sitting with Abu Ubaidah and he got into the pulpit and he started saying, wallahi, I used to be a shepherd when he was Amir al-Mu'mineen, and I used to do this work, this handy work and this handy work. Abu Ubaidah tells him, you went to the pulpit and then you put yourself down, you did not say nasiha, you did not say anything. He says, ya Abu Ubaidah, حدثتني نفسي بالإمارة بالخلافة. Myself is talking to me about my status now and I wanted to remind myself of my past, so I bring it down. شوف, ولما when he was walking in the mud to be handed over the keys of بيت المقدس, فابو عبيدة tells him, يا أمير المؤمنين, these people like prestigious leaders, what will happen if they see like this, see you like this? يا أبا عبيدة, لقد كنا أذل قوم فأعزنا الله بالإسلام. We were the most humiliated and Allah honored us with Islam. Oh. فالأعمى is actually admitting that he was blind, he was poor. And then he said, فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ بَصَرِي, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restored my vision to me. I did not get it because of operation here and there. He is admitting that the bounty from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Any bounty which you have is from Allah. وبعدين تحدث بها, تكلم بها. Speak of it. Speak of it. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. But not in a boastful way. يعني when we go, لما بنروح نرجع بلادنا مصر ومش عارف ايه, طبعا the people look at the someone who coming from America, يعني always ايه, American. فيجوا ما شاء الله, ده انت يعني Allah has given you a lot, ما شاء الله, you have money, معاك فلوس وعربية وكار, ما شاء الله. تيجي انت تقول له ايه, American. أمريكا, أنا من. When those two inmates in jail, they approached Yusuf. Huh? نبئنا بتأويله إنا نراك من المحسنين. Huh? You have something different. You have something that we do not have. What did he say? ذلكما مما. Direct people to Allah. When you tell them America, they're going to worship America. But when you tell them this came from Allah, you can be like me. Just turn. You see, that's why, ya ikhwa, alhamd is important. When you praise Allah, is important. You get people to like it. MashaAllah, the brother is really grateful to Allah. I must turn to Allah too. He can give me what he has. MashaAllah, you're a doctor, you're a doctor now. MashaAllah, you have a PhD. Yes, Harvard. Harvard. I went to Harvard. طيب يا سيدي, worship Harvard يا عم الحاج. لا. Direct. Yeah, these are means. I'm not denying the means, يا إخوة. I'm not belittling the means. لكن, believe you me, whatever you're doing, whatever you're having, whatever blessing you're having is from Allah. So, you must remember where you came from if you want to be grateful. You must believe in your heart that it came to you from Allah. You must express this with your tongue. Praise Allah, but not in a boastful way. For, أدي حق الله فيها. أهو الأعمى, take whatever you want. الزكاة, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you wealth, you must give the zakah. You must give sadaqah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you knowledge, share it. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you strength, use it for Allah. أدي حق الله فيها. Everything that Allah given you, Allah is entitled to a right to it, perform it. Comes in number 5, don't ever use it in the disobedience of Allah. If Allah gives you money, you go and open a liquor store. You use the wealth which was given to you by Allah to disobey Allah. If Allah has given you strength, you go and waste it in drinking and smoking weed instead of using it to serve Allah, to serve the deen of Allah in ibadah, help the ummah, volunteering in the masjid. If Allah has given you eyes, you go and look at pornography on the internet, or you look at the Quran. If Allah give you ears, you hear music with it, or you hear the Quran with it. There are people who are deaf. There are people who are blind. Allah giving you these bounties. Utilize it in the obedience of Allah. This is how you can say Alhamdulillah. He told him, look, take anything that you want from my sheep. Wallahi la aqulu laka la. By Allah, I will never say no to you. فَقَالَ لَهُ يَا هَذَا He said to him, يا هذا بارك الله لك في مالك. May Allah bless your wealth. إن الله ابتلاكم. Allah has tested the three of you. They both flunk. And you succeeded. Because he showed gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Alhamdulillah, but practically. Again, ya ikhwa, to show gratefulness to Allah, you must always recall, where were you before now and then, before you have what you have. You must believe in your heart that whatever you have is from Allah, not because of your means. You must speak of it to spread the praises of Allah in the tongues and to make the ears of people hear it. But again, don't speak of it in a boastful way, rather in a humble way. أدي حق الله فيها. Give the right of Allah in the bounty. Zakah. Give the zakah. Number five, never use it in the disobedience of Allah. If you do this, you have practically said Alhamdulillah. But if you miss any of those, it's a fake Alhamdulillah. Very quickly, inshallah, in the last 7 minutes I still have, just some of the hadith about Alhamdulillah. وفي الغالب يا إخوة it's always سبحان الله وبحمده. Listen to this in the two صحيح. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه: من قال في يوم 100 مرة سبحان الله وبحمده غفر الله ذنوبه ولو كانت مثل زبد البحر. Imagine this, if you say subhanallah wa bihamdi 100 times a day, Allah will forgive your sins even if they are the size or the amount of the foam of the sea. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanallah, 10 minutes. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, 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 100 times. في صحيح مسلم the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he left for Fajr حديث أبي هريرة and he left his wife جويرية بنت الحارث رضي الله عنها and after she prayed Fajr she sat and she started remembering Allah سبحانه وتعالى the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم returned to her after ضحى يعني mid morning فقال لها he said to her You still in the same place where I left you. What you been doing? She said, O Messenger of Allah, I've been remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said to her, لَقَدْ قُلْتُ بَعْدَكِ 4 كَلِمَاتٍ 3 مَرَّاتٍ لَوْ وَزَنَتْ أَوْ لَوْ وُزِنَتْ بِمَا قُلْتِ لَوَزَنَتْهُنْ I have said 4 words 3 times. If they are in the pan of the scale and what you've been doing for the whole time in the other pan of the scale, those 4 words being said 3 times will outweigh them. What did he say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Subhanallah wa bihamdih, adada khalqih, warida nafsih, wazinata arshih, وَمِدَادَ كَلِمَاتِهِ 3 times every morning. سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ عَدَدَ خَلْقِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ The number of his creation. Imagine the trees, the mountains, the insects, the animals. وَرِضَى نَفْسِهِ And who knows this but Allah? وَمِدَادَ كَلِمَاتِ وَزِنَةَ عَرْشِ And the ornament of his throne وَمِدَادَ كَلِمَاتِ وصية إبراهيم. Look at this يا إخوة. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في حديث ابن مسعود في سنن الإمام الترمذي. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم لقيت إبراهيم ليلة أسري بي. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says I met Ibrahim the night of المعراج, الإسراء والمعراج. فقال لي يا محمد, he said to me, oh Muhammad, أقرئ أمتك مني السلام. Are you going to answer سيدنا إبراهيم? Convey my salam to your ummah. Come on, say وعليه السلام. Answer the salam to سيدنا إبراهيم. He sent you salam. وعليه السلام. وأخبرهم, and tell them, أن الجنة طيبة التربة عزبة الماء وأنها قيعان وأن غراسها سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. Tell them that paradise, Jannah, is beautiful. Its soil is wonderful. Its water so sweet. قيعان even. And if you want to plant trees in Jannah, all you have to do is to say سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. Another wording of this hadith, he says من قال سبحان الله وبحمده غرست له نخلة في الجنة. If you say سبحان الله وبحمده, you will have a palm tree in Jannah. طب imagine, سبحان الله وبحمده, سبحان الله وبحمده, سبحان الله وبحمده, سبحان الله وبحمده, سبحان الله وبحمده. 5 seconds. How many palm trees? 5. And by the way, the trunk of the trees in Jannah are made out of what? Gold. Lovers of gold. Here it is in Jannah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, حديث أبي مالك الأشعري رضي الله عنه, والحديث في مسلم, الطهور شطر الإيمان. Being in a state of tahara is half of the faith. Look at this. والحمد لله تملأ الميزان. يا إخوة, في حديث في مستدرك الحاكم, حديث صحيح, صححه الإمام الذهبي, حديث سلمان الفارسي رضي الله عنه. The Prophet says the scale has two pans. If you place the heavens and the earth in one pan of the scale, it will take them. Huge pan. كفة الميزان, huge. For the angels will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا رب لمن هذا الميزان? Who can come up with deeds that will fill the scale? Allah will say to them, لمن شئت من عبادي, to whomever I wish, I will for my servants. Oh, الحمد لله will fill what? Fill the scale. The angels will say, سبحانك ما عبدناك حق عبادتك. All praise to you. We have not worshipped you enough. The last hadith في صحيح البخاري, the last hadith, حديث أبي هريرة, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن ثقيلتان في الميزان. Two words, easy on the tongue, heavy in the scale, beloved to Allah, سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. أهو. The last حديث إن شاء الله, حديث رفاعة ابن رافع رضي الله عنه, والحديث في صحيح البخاري. The companion says كنا يوما نصلي مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. One day we were praying with the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then he said سمع الله لمن حمده. when he came back from the ruku', he said what? سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ. And he heard one of his companions saying, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ حَمْدًا كَثِيرًا طَيِّبًا مُبَارَكًا فِيهِ. After he finished the salah, فَلَمَّا انْصَرَفَ مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ قَالَ مَنْ قَالَ هَذَا مَنِ الْمُتَكَلِّمُ. Who made that statement? Who said, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ حَمْدًا طَيِّبًا كَثِيرًا مُبَارَكًا فِيهِ. فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ, one of his companions said, أَنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, me, O Messenger of Allah. قَالَ وَاللَّهِ, by Allah, لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ بِضْعَةً وَثَلَاثِينَ مَلَكًا يَبْتَذِرُونَهَا أَيُّهُمْ يَكْتُبُهَا. I saw 30 plus angels fighting one another. Who would write it first and before the other? فيا إخوة أكثروا من الحمد لله. القرآن, the Quran started, سورة الفاتحة, الحمد لله. فأكثروا من الحمد لله. When somebody asks you, how are you, brother? Say, الحمد لله. When you speak about something good in your, الحمد لله. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ. Allah loves. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْضَى. Allah is pleased with you praising Him. بإذن الله تعالى, the next lecture will continue with رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. We just explained Alhamdulillah. Huh? We said we're going to take our time, no? سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم.